Hey guys, today we're talking about the Justice League Dark Annual number one, so let's jump into it not by James Tynion IV, he did not do, I think, the annual, let me look here. He did James Tynion IV and Ram 4 came off with the story. Ram 4 is a dialogue, so I would technically say James Tynion IV and Ram 5. So yeah, so let's jump into it. It's called Curious Bloom. So let's jump into it. Do we have the Tanner talking about how magic needs to be rewritten and everything, like all these books need to be like taken out, they need to be taken out so we can and rip them up and do stuff so we can like take them out so we can change them, because magic is being rewritten so it's in new ways, so these ways won't work anymore, they gotta change it. And Constantine comes in, he talks to Swamp Thing, he's like, yo, I have to talk to you, Swamp Thing, about something. And I was like, okay, cool, can I get some coffee with the Lou, and I still don't know, can I get a kettle? Like, can I get some tea in West Lua, and can I get some tea? And to talk to him about, okay, what the hell's going on, Constantine? Why, there's a new Parliament of Green and all this, we have a new Chosen One who's going to be the King. The Parliament of the Green, which is the thing Swamp Thing was a part of. He was the Guardian of the Green, but now he's not anymore. So they have to, he's like, hey, go, you need to go to the new, yourself, I know you need to go get the new Guardian of the Green, you need to go check it out, you need to go like make sure you can help him and save him, that's the plan. So Constantine convinces him to go and save it. It's like, damn you the hell, Constantine. He's like, yeah, well, he goes off. And then we cut to up in Rob's and Maine. This guy's in a cabin, all this guy comes home to his cabin looking for a girlfriend, Nate, and he finds out all the stuff happened. Oh, not all the stuff happened, but everything's really loud. Like, the TV's really loud, the key telephone's really loud, the radio's really loud. I'm like, I'm sorry, I couldn't take the quiet and loneliness. I'm like, first of all, you're in Maine. First of all, good. How quiet is it? I feel like it should be that quiet in Maine. I don't think it's ever been that quiet, but it's weird. And then eventually they got into fights and stuff. They had a son or something, and he died. And now they from something, and then they had to. Then he defensively decides to leave, and he gets to. And he starts to get into his walk, and then something happens. Like, he's like a scientist or something, and he does stuff with flowers and stuff. Something happens, and then he comes back, and he's like this now, like, flower creature. It's actually a really cool design. I like it. If we can share it. Yeah, it's pretty cool. I like it. He's like, what the hell? I'm this now flower creature. What the hell? Swamp Thing talks to him, saying, like, hey, you're the new person of the Green. I'm Swamp Thing. This is my deal. You're the new thing of the Green. I'm like, what? No, the fire. No, I'm this person. And he runs off to quite a go find her. This girl, he finds the place where she's at. And so he kind of goes in and hears about her. And this new guy talking about, hey, why don't we go on this trip? It'll be really good for you. Did you hear that? You go upstairs. Like, oh. That sounds like footsteps. He goes upstairs, nothing's there. The sea creates, finds this other guy who comes in and talks to him. We find out later, it's hard to tell from the beginning part what he looks like. I'm like, who the hell is this guy? I was like, I don't know who the hell this guy is. But then I'm like, who the hell is this guy? And later on, we find out it's the Flying Almanac Man. I'm like, isn't the Flying Almanac Man a villain or a hero? Like, it's kind of like both, I think, at some points. It depends on what's going on, but I'm like, okay, it's just a Flanic Man. So he seems to be behind this. Obviously, he has to do with degree and stuff, so that makes sense. And he convinces him, like, kind of tricks this guy into convincing him to do something. And we come back to the girl, and I'm about to leave, I think, for a trip, or really close to leaving. And they open the door, and they find this kid. And it looks just like her son. It's not, but it's like, way. He looks so much like Gerard, our son. They take him in, and you can see the footsteps. It's not actually a kid, it's like made of like grass and stuff and all this shit. And Swamp Thing is like watching this and seeing all this happen. And then he figures out, Swamp Thing goes to look at all his files and everything and figures out like what the hell happened. And we find out that he actually made two more, another son and a daughter for her, like a girl, another little boy and another girl. And now they're with them, so they're like a giant family kind of thing. And then the mom sees one of them more jump off the thing, off the roof. It's like, oh no, what the hell's going on? Hey, why'd you do that? It's like, I don't know what's going on. It's like, Swamp Thing knows what's going on. He's like, this is bad, I gotta stop this, I gotta fix this. And he goes and he sees the new guy, I forget his name, and he's making all these kids and stuff. He's like, no, you gotta stop this, it's wrong, you died in the stench crisis. You gotta read this file. This piece of paper will tell you everything, and the Flanic Man's like, no, don't listen to him, Then the Philonic Man comes up, like, yep, now he's in his Philonic, now he looked like the Philonic Man right there. So I'm like, okay, cool. And he starts fighting on Swamp Thing, and they get into a fight. And he's like, look at this paper, look at this paper. And the Philonic Man stabs him and all this stuff. And he's like, it looks like he's about to die. The Swamp Thing is like, it looks like the Swamp Thing's about to die. I'm like, oh, shit. And he gets the paper, and he sees it. I'm like, oh, shit, this is what really happened. They go through him. He was in this, he was this guy. He was in this, he was working on this thing, all these chemicals build. He kind of went in the chemicals, he got in the chemicals and stuff, and then kind of, he became this thing. Like, he could kind of, like, it sounds like he killed himself or something, but he did some weird shit. Like, yeah, he did some interesting crap, and he now became this guy. He realizes, like, hey, I'm not this, he realizes, like, hey, I'm not this thing anymore, da-da-da, whatever. But then the one goes off to look for the kids, and she finds out that, he finds out that they're all leaves, they're not actually real, they're all just made of leaves and shit. It's like, oh no, 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 and he like kind of faints. It's like, Molly, he's like, what's wrong, mommy, and then they all just disappear and shit. It's like, oh fuck, this really is kind of sad. I'm like, oh, this is sad, but it's really great. I thought I'm gonna him talk and stuff, and he's like, I'm gonna lay down here and sleep, I just need to sleep for a while, I'll just be fine. And then the Philonic Man starts eating him, and devours him, and becomes, basically combines with him, and becomes this new entity. He starts eating him and stuff. And then we got the Swamp Thing, he gets to go and takes it back inside. But such a bad consciousness, and says, like, you knew this was gonna happen. What's the point of all this? Sometimes there is no point, life just has to, you have to go on with the, go with the flow, you gotta do what life wants. Sometimes it's all just whatever. Sometimes that's how, you can't help it. It's not much you can do, but you just gotta play a story or whatever. So that was great, and then it cuts you back to the Swamp Man, the other guy, and he ate him, and now they're together. And now this other person, Sexy, comes. He's like, ooh, look at Cersei. She kinda changed a bit from when we last saw her. I'm like, oh shit. Probably because, whatchamacallit, Lex Luthor gave her some powers or probably something. So yeah, she's fucking formidable now. And then they kinda team up together. Like, okay, well, we're gonna team up. And then with Super Continuum Justice League 14 the next issue, I think. I think 14's the next issue. So I'm like, yeah, this is actually a really great issue. I really enjoyed this anyway. It was basically a whole issue about Swamp Thing, kind of, a Swamp Thing comic. Kind of, because he was the main focus of him going off and having to deal with stuff with the Green. It did have the other members in it, but they were, like, in it for just not very much. Constantine was in it the most, other than him, other than Swamp Thing. But, yeah, really good book. I love Justice League Dark. This annual, really freaking good. What do I rate this? I'm going to give this one, like, a... I mean, it's really good. Have some really good moments in it. I'm going to give it, like, a... We're gonna put a 9, thought 9, really good, really enjoy it. I recommend if you love Justice League Dark, you should pick this up. This is a really great annual. This is fucking great shit. So Justice League Dark annual number 1, and what do you guys think about it? Let me know in the comments down below and let's talk about it. And you guys can always stay epic. I'll see you next week, guys. Bye.